Alright, hello there everyone. Hello to Blame Truth subscribers. My name is Tommy. I am a Modern Warfare 2 player from England, in case you couldn't tell by the accent. Let me first dispel a few myths about the English. We do not all like tea, although we do all like crumpets, because that is a fact. I do love crumpets. I don't really like cricket though, which we're supposed to apparently. But no, I can't sing the national anthem. But I will first offer a thank you to Anthony for letting me post this on the channel. Very, very kind of you indeed. Hello. This is a game on Afghan Team Deathmatch. Team Deathmatch is my favourite game type in general. It's the one I play the most. I know there's obviously all the different types in there. They're good, I like them. But I just feel like I get more fun out of Team Deathmatch in general. And I'm using my rushing kind of setup here. Marathon Pro, Lightweight Pro, Commando Pro. With Claymores, M21, and Model 1887 Akimbo. So I know quite a lot of people have been complaining a lot about the models recently, because you know, for people think they're overpowered in some way or another. What's my view on it? I do agree that they do outclass the other shotguns a fair bit. So my suggestion to Infinity Ward, if they're watching, which they aren't, but let's pretend they are. I would say reduce the rate of fire of the models. Leave the ranges as it is, because without that range there'd be no real reason to use these shotguns. That is what makes them unique. But reduce the rate of fire, certainly, yeah. I mean, that'd be quite good. As you can tell, I'm pretty bad with the M21, but I think most of the work I do in this game is with the Model 1887s anyway. So about me, what am I? What the fuck do you think I am? I'm a human being, is what I am, but what I am like as a player, which is what I was supposed to say, what I'm like as a player, I like to experiment with different things, much like drugs, and especially with this, you know, M21 lightweight, it doesn't spring to mind instantly, right? Right. And so that's what I'm all about. I like trying out all these new different combinations, seeing if it works. If it does, I keep using it until I get a good game out of it. And this one is quite a nice one to use. M21 I wouldn't necessarily use with it, probably the Barrett more likely, but definitely with a shotgun of your choice, it works pretty well. But if I were to offer a tip to someone who hasn't used these models before, as a Kimber, I'd say whatever you do, don't fire them both at once. Yes, there are some times when it is helpful, like if you need that extra bit of range, but in general I'd say fire one at a time, because effectively if you're firing them alternately instead of at the same time, you're effectively doubling your rate of fire, which is good. And you know, singularly, I think is the word, if you're firing them singularly, you're still getting some decent range on them. It's pretty damn good either way. And the Ranger Akimbo is sort of the close range alternative to this. You might be thinking, well, what's the point in having, you know, close range, we can have long range like this. I find the Rangers much more reliable at close range. Why, I'm not sure. Maybe they just are more likely to kill, the spread of bullets, I don't know. But it just seems like they're more comfortable to use at close range. And, you know, they reload faster, and obviously you can fire both one after the other if you want, as opposed to the models you have to wait. So there is still reason to use all the other ones too. So let me say a bit about Afghan. Afghan is quite a wide open map, as you probably all know. but I thought I'd, you know, go around with the models a bit and give it a go. It's fun, right? That's what it's all about. And the M21, I'd highly recommend scavenger for it. Because if you waste as much ammo as I do, you need it. And I really should have put it on. But, you know, still have the shotguns afterwards. My killstreak setup is has slipped out of my mind. But it was probably... Okay, we'll soon see anyway. I would have thought I'd have one by now, but I don't know. I think I was trying for a nuke for a while, but then I just gave up because I got bored. Oh, there we go. Pavlos is one of the first ones. It was Predator, Pavlo, and AC-130, I remember. Now, regarding the killstreaks, I know people like to complain about how overpowered they are. Usually these are people who don't know what a Stinger missile is, but... the reason I've chosen these particular ones is because Pavlo Predator missile is very versatile. I mean, you will very reliably get at least one kill from it. And if needs be, you can also use it to shoot down enemy air support, like a chopper gun or something. But, I like this bit, by the way. Pavlo is a very reliable source of kills, even though it's not as, you know, massively damaging as a stealth bomber or whatever. It's a good, steady source of kills. And the AC-130 is basically a version of the chopper gunner which has less potential to kill in most cases, because, you know, chopper gunner can just hold it down, spray, whatever. But this thing is harder to shoot down because it has more flares, I believe. I might be wrong, someone correct me. But yeah, and it's more fun to use, I found. So I feel like I'm somewhat less of a noob by using it, so. Alright, so at least on Afghan it's a wide open map, and the AC-130 is actually pretty good on it. And obviously in the likes of Domination, Ground War, well actually you can have Ground War Domination or just plain Domination, whatever, games in which people are likely to cluster together, that is when the AC-130 really shines, you know. Easy to get a few, you know, quad kills from that massive big old cannon you get. And so here, really, I know I'm out of M21 ammo, so I'm just waiting for that guy over there shooting me to die. And I apologize about the poor quality microphone I'm using, but it's literally all I've got. I mean, I thought I had another one. I was looking for it a minute ago, but apparently it's broken, so... Yeah. What do you do when you're out of ammo? Pick up another gun. Whatever it is, you pick it up. Something's better than nothing. So, and it was a P90 with holographic, incidentally. I think it's holographic. Another little mini tip here for the using akimbo weapons. If you find yourself in a situation where you know you'll kill them with one shot, obviously just fire one of them, but also fire the same one each time for these single kills. And I'll explain what I mean. If you've ended up with you know, both guns and one of them desperately needs to be reloaded and one of them doesn't, you start the reloading animation, and the one that loads in will be finished up, finished done, will be finished reloading sooner, and they're independent, so you can have one still reloading and have the other one ready to fire, if you know what I mean. It's just a good tactic to use, I found. So I think I'll go for a little dive bomb here off the edge with, thanks to Commando Pro. That is what Commando Pro does. It makes you immune to damage from falling, which is always good to have. Makes me feel like Spider-Man jumping off stuff. And So the game is about to come to a close. Big thanks to Blametrilly for letting me post this on channel. You're the man, BT. And yeah, make sure you rate, comment, and all that stuff. And if you like, visit my channel, which I'll put at the end here. So many thanks. Bye bye.